Hi, I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. If you would like to learn the very basics of how to do tracking in HitFilm, then you have come to the right place. So tracking is a vital and important part in the video making process, especially if you're going to add different special effects. For example, you might add a lightsaber effect, or you might draw in the air, or I have also done a witness protection effect. I did a finger beams effect one time that required tracking. I attached text labels to different things, and I even changed eye colors as well. And all of those things require that you know how to use the tracking tools. So say, for example, I want to add a flame effect into this panning shot. Okay, here's how I would do it. I would take my raw footage and I would want to make it into a composite shot. So in this case, I'm going to right click on it and say make into a composite shot. Click OK. So here's my footage and here's where I'm going to have the flame happen. So what I need to do is I need to track that as it moves across the view of the camera. So I'm going to open up the footage, and the very first item is tracks, and there's a little plus icon, and if you hover over it, says insert tracker. So I'm going to click on that, and that is going to be my tracker. Now you'll notice that we went from a viewer to a layer look at it. Okay, the layer means I'm only going to look at this one layer. The viewer means I'm looking at everything that's in this shot. So we're going to go to the layer view. And when we do that, you can see that I have these items here now sitting in the middle of the shot. What I'm going to do is use my mouse wheel and scroll in on them a little bit. So you can see that we have three things. We have an outside green box, we have an inside red box, and then we have a dot in the middle of everything. If I grab on the outside green box, I'll only move it. If I grab on the inside the red, though, I can move everything, okay? If I use my right mouse button, I can drag my footage over here a little bit. And then if I use my left mouse button, I can drop it into here where I want it to be, okay? Now, the outside green box is where the software is going to be looking for what we're looking for. The inside red box is what we want the software to find. And then the dot is where we want the footage to record that data. Okay, so I have placed the dot right in the middle of this candle. And I have placed the tracking area to be around the top of that. And then I've made a big enough green box that I think we'll be okay. I'm going to use my mouse wheel to scroll out here a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to start the track. I'm starting at the beginning, okay, but I could start at the end and track backwards, but I'm going to start at the beginning and track forwards. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this at single point, position only. Optical flow will be fine, okay? And then this is the track controls, and I can either click on this and have it go, or I can do this and track forward one frame at a time. I'm going to have it go, so I'm just going to click on this and it will start tracking until it is done. So now this data has been tracked all the way across, and I did speed that up, but it didn't take very long to do. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to transform that into a placeholder. So what I'm going to do is create a new point layer by clicking here and then clicking on this point. You'll notice the whole screen goes black. Why is that? Well, that's because we're on layer view. Again, layer view only views whatever layer you're on. And since the point is just a point, there is nothing to see. So I'm going to go back to the viewer view so that I can see everything. Okay. Now under the tracker, I'm going to say transform this to that new point right here. And don't forget to click apply, and we're transporting the, or we're transforming the X position and the Y position and apply. Okay. So now if you open up the new point, you can see that all that data is now been transferred into that point. And if I go back to the beginning and I highlight the point, you can see as I play through this that that point is actually following exactly along with the candle that is on the table. And that's exactly what I want. So now that I have that, I can go ahead and attach my special effect to that. So for example, I may go out and get myself a flame effect. And this flame effect comes from Footage Crate or Production Crate. And I will leave a link in the description below. It's a free asset that you can get. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come back to the beginning. I will drop this flame effect in here. Okay. And if I start moving forward, you can see there is the flame effect, right? All I have to do is take it and put it where I want it. I may want to rescale it a little bit, you know, just to be sure that it's the right size. Oh, you know, maybe there. Okay, put it exactly on the spot. And then I'm just going to click here on this icon and say parent it to the new point. So now that flame effect has been parented, and everywhere that the point goes, that flame is going to go. And so when you play this now, you can see that that flame has been attached directly to that position in the candle. And that is the value of tracking. So if you have any questions about how to do tracking in HitFilm, or you have any feedback, please feel free to drop them in the comments below. And thanks for watching.